What the fuck?
I'm gonna break my rusty cage and run.
Yo there guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be going over what makes a good zombies player and how to get better at zombies, so you can learn off this video as well as watching it. So, in the last video, I did 10 things that smart zombie players do, and hopefully some of you guys learned off that or just having fun watching it. I hope you enjoyed that video. But before we get started, I just wanted to say that a good zombies player isn't always a streamer that sits there on his mad gaming chair with his amazing headset and sits there with the Apothecan until round 255 on a stream that took 30 hours. That's not what makes a good zombies player. So anyway, you'll see what makes a good one in these. So let's just get into the first one. So one of the key things that makes a good zombies player, I believe in my opinion, is patience. Now, zombies can be a very fast game or a very long game that can possibly go on for weeks, depending how long you actually survive for. Obviously, round 255 is the cap of rounds, so you can't go higher than that. So you could stay, if you were good enough, you could stay on round 255 for your whole life, which is like that. What's the average human lifespan, like 70 something years, late 70s? So you could sit there on round 255 for nearly 80 years with the Apothecan on Revelations, which is one of the easiest maps to get around 100 on, as you can see in the gameplay here. So patience is key in zombies, to get Easter eggs done, to build certain things, to get certain steps done, to upgrade certain things. The box, if you want to get a certain weapon from the box, you got to sit there and be patient, unless you get lucky and get it first spin. But patience is a key thing in zombies, so just be patient and don't try rush things. If you know that something isn't gonna go fucking bastard, I stuttered that. As I was saying, if you know something isn't gonna go well, then don't try and rush in there and try get it done. Say if there's a player down, don't rush in there, have patience to kill the zombies and make sure that you're safe. Because if you run in there and you go down trying to revive a player, it's just two players down, which causes even more of a mess, and then they have to res two more players, which could cause more risk of another plane going down. So just be patient with zombies and just let things go at their own pace. Anyway, let's get into the next one. Next up might be fairly obvious, but it's having the ability to get stuff done on low rounds, so you have a better chance of getting a high round, such as building a shield, getting pack-a-punch on low rounds, getting certain weapons on low rounds, upgrading certain weapons on low rounds, hitting the box to get certain weapons on low rounds, just stuff like that. So for example, in Revelations, upgrading the Apothecan, getting pack-a-punch, getting Lolani's, getting Ragnarok's, shield, all that, purple jug, all that type of jazz to get you to the high rounds. What the fuck did I just say? This video is an absolute flop, but I'm going to carry on because I can't be asked restarting. So, as I was saying, get stuff done on low rounds in preparation and in advance for the high rounds. Anyway, let's move on to the next one. This is going to be the last one because I've already fucked up this video enough and you don't need fucking up more. But anyway, the last one is good communication skills. Now, every single good player should have some good form of communication skills, just so it's easier to actually get stuff done in the game. Because if you're sat there and you need to do a step, say to upgrade the sword, you need help with Magwars or something in Shadows, and there's a guy there sat on his Turtle Beach headset, can hear everybody saying but can't reply because he's sat there and his mum's in bed sleeping and it's 3 a.m. and he can't talk to you, what is the point of me even playing the game? Like, why are you even in a co-op game if that's the case? You should always have good communication with your teammates so it's easy to get stuff done.
I'm tired of fearing it's useless. Your word don't mean nothing, it's useless.